Hello, friends. Ben Ochart here. Thank you so much for tuning in. Something was just delivered at my house, and I'm going to go check it out. And okay, I'm pretty sure this is the box I've been expecting from Brandon, the blind fish keeper on YouTube. Check out his channel. And so I took it downstairs to the garage fish room, and I cut it open. And what I was expecting is a fish that I've been looking for quite some time. I had picked one up previously, but he turned out to be an older fish and he didn't last that long. So Brandon knew that I really liked this fish, and so he reached out to me and offered to send me some. And these are ones that were bred by him and born in his tanks. So he was sending me six of them, and I could grow them out and then pick go ahead and pick the pick of the litter, if you will, and then either give away or sell the other ones, or maybe even breed them. We'll see. And this is the first time he shipped fish, and his packing looked pretty good. There was a little water in there. These three look in real good shape. As you can see, they're active, moving around. Always a good sign. And but unfortunately, it looks like the second bag, based on both the look of the water and the smell, they didn't make it. But I took the ones that did make it and rinsed off the bag and floated them in the tank for roughly about 20 minutes. And naturally, the other fish were very, very curious. This 55 is essentially a quarantine tank full of fish that I had just received and that I'm growing out. I turned the lights down just to minimize the amount of stress and shock on these new guys. And after floating them, I went ahead and did my normal flop and drop, cut open the bag, and just pour them through a net into a net, letting the water go into the bucket. It looks like it might be a little bit traumatic on the fish, but the truth is that it's not. It's actually more traumatic to slowly like trickle water, especially after they've been traveling for quite some time. They can end up in real bad shape. So I went ahead and transferred them to the tank, and the other fish started to show some curiosity. They can't fit in the mouth of any of the fish that are in the tank, so I don't think that any of them are going to be going after them or trying to eat them. But they were certainly curious. At this stage, with that dot, you know, that spot in the middle of the body, they almost look a little bit like one of the geos. But as you can see, the other fish were curious, but were not really attacking or going after them. The Nicaraguan cichlids showed the most interest. But for the most part, they got in the tank and started hanging out. And now comes the real test, which is that first 24 hours after you add them. We'll see how they do. I'll show them on Saturday during the live stream and give you an update on how they look and how they're getting along with the other fish. And of course, very importantly, how they're eating, which is a sign that is vital to how new fish are doing when you add them to an aquarium. So what I have here are three green terrors. And these are not the orange or yellow fringed tail. These are the white fringe. So you have, I guess, an orange som and a white. These are the white variety. I'm already seeing some little blue lines on the faces. So I'm very excited about these little guys growing out. I'm sorry the other three didn't make it. And UPS was delayed by one day for some reason unknown to me, but maybe Brandon, if you're watching, you can get them to at least refund your postage, because it did, I believe, that did contribute to that second bag not making it. All it takes is one fish to die, and the pollution process starts with a high amount of ammonia being created. But fortunately, the second bag made it, and the three little guys look good, and I am anxious to grow them out. So let's go ahead and turn the lights down and let them chill and relax and recover. And tomorrow morning, I'll turn the lights back on, give them a feeding, and check them out. And on Saturday, I'll go ahead and show them to you again during the live stream. If you like the content in the channel, please be sure to hit that sub button and the bell, and of course a thumbs up. This tells YouTube you like what's going on. Follow on Instagram for some behind the scenes looks, and we have a great group over on Facebook. Check that out if you can, and comment below. We all learn from each other around here. Hope to see you on Saturday at the Cichlids and Coffee live stream. That's 11 a.m. Central, that's 9 a.m. Pacific, or noon Eastern. Great group of fish keepers from all over the world talking about how to better take care of our finned friends. If you'd like to support the channel, consider becoming a member of the Garage Gang. And that is a Patreon membership. Memberships start as little as $3 a month, and it really helps with the continual creation of content and the building out of the garage. Just click on the Patreon icon at the bottom right of the channel banner. You can't miss it, and it'll take you to a special video that talks about what Patreon is. Thank you so much.